Taken together, it was a dreadfully long name to weigh down a poor innocent child, and one of the hardest lessons I ever learned was to remember my own name. When I grew up, I just called myself O.Z., because the other initials were P-I-N-H-E-A-D, and that spelled pinhead, which was a reflection on my intelligence.
"Surely no one could blame you for cutting your name short," said Ozma sympathetically. "But didn't you cut it almost too short?"
"Perhaps so," replied the Wizard. "When a young man, I ran away from home and joined a circus. I used to call myself a wizard and do tricks of ventriloquism."
"What does that mean?" asked the Princess.
"Throwing my voice into any object I pleased, to make it appear that the object was speaking instead of me. Also, I began to make balloon ascensions. On my balloon, and on all the other articles I used in the circus, I painted the two initials O.Z. to show that those things belonged to me. One day my balloon ran away with me and brought me across the deserts to this beautiful country. When the people saw me come from the sky, they naturally thought me some superior creature and bowed down before me. I told them I was a wizard and showed them some easy tricks that amazed them, and when they saw the initials painted on the balloon, they called me Oz."
"Now I begin to understand," said the Princess, smiling.
"At that time," continued the Wizard, busily eating his soup while talking, "there were four separate countries in this land, each one of the four being ruled by a witch. But the people thought my power was greater than that of the witches, and perhaps the witches thought so too, for they never dared oppose me. I ordered the Emerald City to be built just where the four countries cornered together, and when it was completed, I announced myself the ruler of the Land of Oz, which included all the four countries of the Munchkins, the Gillikins, the Winkies, and the Quadlings. Over this land I ruled in peace for many years, until I grew old and longed to see my native city once again. So when Dorothy was first blown to this place by a cyclone, I arranged to go away with her in a balloon, but the balloon escaped too soon and carried me back alone. After many adventures, I reached Omaha, only to find that all my old friends were dead or had moved away. So having nothing else to do, I joined a circus again and made my balloon ascensions until the earthquake caught me.